So in so we are in the fifth chapter of our syllabus. It is related to psychrometry. Psychrometry, as I said earlier, it is a study of moist air. So we are dealing with the properties of moist air, various processes involved in it. So in processes, we started with the sensible cooling, sensible heating. In sensible heating, we are only increasing its dry bulb temperature without altering its specific humidity. So we are not adding moisture, we are not removing moisture. We are just simply increasing the temperature. Then next was humidification and dehumidification. In humidification, we are increasing the specific humidity. That means we are increasing only moisture content without altering its temperature. So dry bulb temperature remains constant. It's only specific humidity increases. So there is a psychrometric diagram on your screen. So here you can see this is one relative humidity phi 1. This is a phi 2. So we are at a point P1. Okay, so point P1 has some dry bulb temperature of 30 degrees Celsius and specific humidity of W1. Now, in humidification, what happens? I increase the moisture content. So, when I increase the moisture content in a humidification process, also as the name suggests, its moisture content will increase. So, initially, specific humidity was W1, it will increase to W2. So, it will go up to W2. So this is the process of humidification. Without altering its dry bulb temperature, I am increasing its moisture content. And vice versa, if I am at point P1, it is having some specific humidity, let us say W1. And if I am removing the moisture content from it without altering its dry bulb temperature, if I come to W2, so I am decreasing its moisture content. So this is the process of dehumidification. So we have humidification and dehumidification. Then if I combine this sensible heating, cooling, and humidification and dehumidification, so I have some mixed process here. So first process here, it is a heating and humidification. So I'm increasing the dry bulb temperature as well as I'm increasing its specific humidity. So as you can see here, if this is my point P1, I'm increasing the temperature as well as I'm increasing its specific humidity. Second, I have here is heating and dehumidification. So I am increasing my dry bulb temperature. So in heating and dehumidification, I am increasing my dry bulb temperature, but I am decreasing its specific humidity. So as you can see here, this is my point P1. So heating means it will go in right direction. Dehumidification means it will go in downward direction. So this will be my resultant point, that is a P2. So point P2 will have higher temperature than P1, but lesser specific humidity. So that is a heating and dehumidification. So this is what in a manufacturing process or a food processing industries, it happens. This is a process of drying. जस तुम्हाला जसं की गाजराचे तुकडे असतात, फळांचे स्लाइस असतात, टोमॅटो असते, ते तुम्हाला जर पावडर करायचे असेल फूड प्रोसेसिंग इंडस्ट्री, त्यात काय केलं जातं, हिटिंग केलं जातं आणि त्यातलं मॉइश्चर कंटेंट रिमूव्ह केलं जातं. Afterwards, you will get a dried fruit. So from that, you can produce a powder. So this is the process of heating and dehumidification, which is generally used in drying processes. Okay. Next, we have seen this third process, which is a cooling and dehumidification. So cooling means its temperature will reduce, but humidification means its specific humidity or the moisture content in that air will also increase. So cooling means dry bulb temperature will reduce, but humidity will increase. This specific humidity will increase. So again, we are at point P1 here. So as I am saying here, cooling, that means my dry bulb temperature will reduce. Okay. Humidification means it will go in upward direction. Its specific humidity will increase. So I'm reducing the temperature, but I'm increasing its specific humidity. The resultant process will go in this direction. Okay, so point P1. So this will be my point P2. So this is the case of cooling and humidification. And fourth was cooling and dehumidification. So I'm reducing the dry bulb temperature as well as I'm reducing the specific humidity. So cooling means temperature will reduce. Dehumidification means moisture content will reduce. So this is the case here. Point P1 is here. Its temperature will decrease as well as its moisture content will also decrease. Now, if I show all these processes, on a single psychrometric diagram. So here we have drive up temperature versus a specific humidity, and it is bounded by relative humidity 100%. Now this is my point P1, which is shown by a circle here. If I go in horizontal direction here, so this will be my sensible heating. If I go horizontal direction, in this direction, so this will be my sensible cooling. If I go in upward direction, so this will be my process of humidification. If I go in downward direction, this will be my process of dehumidification. So this is a simple way. It is also shown here, sensible heating, okay, sensible cooling, dehumidification and humidification. Now if I go for mixed processes, again I have here heating and dehumidification. So I'm increasing the temperature but reducing the moisture content. Here I have cooling and dehumidification, so I'm reducing the temperature and reducing its moisture content. Then I have here heating and humidification, so I'm heating as well as increasing the moisture content. Then I have here cooling and humidification, so this is I'm reducing the temperature but I'm increasing the moisture content. Okay, so you remember this diagram. This diagram will clear your concept about all the processes on a psychrometric diagram: sensible heating, sensible cooling, humidification, dehumidification, and other mixed processes. Okay, now there is very important and very interesting processes here, which is called as evaporator cooling. जे तुम्ही आपल्या एरियामध्ये आपण वॉटर कूलर समर मध्ये वापरत असतो त्या कूलर मध्ये आपण पाणी भरतो आणि मग कूलर चालू करतो, राईट? त्या कूलरच्या मागे एक प्रकारची जाळी असते, त्या जाळीतून पाणी कंटिन्युअसली ड्रिप होत असते अँड इट हॅज अ फॅन इन फ्रंट ऑफ इट. सो फॅन क्रिएट्स अ एअर फ्लो अँड मॉइश्चर इज ॲडेड फ्रॉम दॅट कूलर टू द एअर. आणि मग त्या एअर मधलं मॉइश्चर वाढल्यामुळे आपल्याला ते एअर अशी थंड वाटते, राईट? So what is that process? That is nothing but evaporative cooling. Okay, so again I will explain on a psychrometric diagram. This is a psychrometric diagram. This is a dry bulb temperature. This is again specific humidity. This is a curve of 100% RH. Okay, now I have temperature. Suppose the Pandaprata temperature in summer, it can go up to, let us say I take 35 degrees Celsius, right? And this inclined lines are my wet bulb temperature line. So this is a wet bulb temperature line. Okay, so evaporative cooling means I am adding a moisture as well as I am cooling it. So in that case, this point P1 will follow its WBT line. So this is, this dash line is WBT line. So cooling process will take place on this line. So this temperature will reduce, will reduce, will reduce, will reduce, will reduce, and maximum it can reduce up to its WBT temperature, wet bulb temperature. Okay, so if a person asks you, like if I'm using a air cooler in summer, तर त्यांना माझं किती मॅक्सिमम किंवा मिनिमम टेम्परेचर किती मिळू शकतं, सो इट कॅन गो अप टू इट्स ड्राय बल्ब वेट बल्ब टेम्परेचर. ओके, सो युअर युअर इफ युअर कंडिशन हिअर इन समर, सो इफ आय टेक इन पंढरपूर, इट्स अ ड्राय बल्ब टेम्परेचर इज 35 डिग्री सेल्सिअस, 35 डिग्री सेल्सिअस डीबीटी. इट्स अ वेट बल्ब टेम्परेचर, सपोज इट इज 22 और लेट अस से 28 डिग्री सेल्सिअस वेट बल्ब टेम्परेचर. इफ आय एम युझिंग इव्हॅपोरेटिव कूलिंग, so in that case its temperature can maximum reduce up to, or minimum it can go up to 28 degree celsius. So it can go minimum up to its wet bulb temperature. Okay, but if I am using ACs, air conditioner, split air conditioner, in that case so I have a control on temperature. My remote asto, remote na me temperature adjust karu shakto, but in case of air cooler that madhe apan pani bharat asto, tyamadhe my control nasto ki किती टेम्परेचर रिड्यूस होईल. सो मॅक्सिमम ऑर मिनिमम इट कॅन रिड्यूस अप टू 28 डिग्री सेल्सिअस अप टू इट्स वेट बल्ब टेम्परेचर. ओके, दिस इज अ व्हेरी इम्पॉर्टंट पॉइंट, प्लीज रिमेंबर. इफ आय एम युझिंग अ एअर कूलर, इन दॅट केस टेम्परेचर कॅन रिड्यूस टू अप टू इट्स वेट बल्ब टेम्परेचर. ओके, सो इफ यू वॉन्ट टू ड्रॉ यू कॅन ड्रॉ. So when this point P1 will reach to the saturation line, we can say air is saturated. So this can be point P2. This can be here also point P2 dash, Somewhere on this line, the evaporator cooling will take place. So same process I will show you on psychrometric diagram. So again, I have a psychrometric diagram here. Okay, so like I said, if the outside temperature is 40 degrees Celsius and its wet bulb temperature is suppose 20 degrees Celsius, so this will go up to this. So this will be my outside point or initial point. If I using an evaporator cooler or the air cooler, what we use in summer, we use water in that case. So it can go like this. So this is its WBT line, this dash line. The temperature will reduce on this line. Okay, so it can stop here. So this will be my point P2. Okay, so or it can go up to this also. So P2 dash, or it can go up to this also. So minimum it can reduce or up to is wet bulb temperature. So you can see a wet bulb temperature 20 degrees Celsius. So cooling process or final temperature would be 20 degrees Celsius. Okay. So this is the case of evaporative cooling. And these are the some images of commercial products. So first, as you see here, this is a steamer. आपण जे वाफ घ्यायला वापरतो. So in that case of steamer, it is continuously ejecting steam. So this is the process of, as you can see, this is the process of humidification. I am adding moisture content to the air. So this is a case of humidification. Next, what you see here, this is the dehumidifier. So dehumidifier. In that case, this dehumidifier takes the outside air in. It removes its moisture. So inside this dehumidifier, there are some materials like silicon wafer will be there. It will capture the moisture in the air and the outside air. So somewhere here there will be an exit to the air. So this air will have a less specific humidity or less moisture content. So this is a dehumidifier. Now this is a very familiar image to you. This is the air cooler you are using. So at the back side of it, these are the mesh. त्याच्यामध्ये कंटिन्युअसली तुमचं आपण वॉटर टाकलेलं असतं, ते वॉटर त्यातून ड्रिप होत असतंय, राईट. सो वॉटर इज हिअर समवेअर, दिस इज अ वॉटर टँक. सो यू कॅन वॉच द वॉटर लेवल ऑन दिस मीटर. सो देर इज अ मोटर इन साईड दिस कंटिन्युअसली पंपिंग द वॉटर अँड स्प्रेइंग इट ऑन दिस मेश. वॉटर इज ड्रिपिंग अँड देन देर इज अ फॅन हिअर. सो फॅन विल क्रिएट अन एअर फ्लो अँड दॅट एअर विल टेक द मॉइश्चर ऑर द वॉटर पार्टिकल्स अँड दॅट air with a higher humidity will come in contact with our skin and there will be again a cooling effect will be observed. Okay, so this is a case of evaporative cooling. Maximum it can reduce or like minimum temperature we can get is its wet bulb temperature. Right, so as the name suggests, here this is adding a moisture content. So this will be a humidifier. This is removing the moisture content. So this is a dehumidifier and this is adding the moisture content, but it is following that evaporative line. So this is a evaporative cooling. Now the next point here is a sensible heat factor. This is a, in short, it is written as SHF. Now SHF, it is a straight away ratio of, so SHF, sensible heat factor, is a ratio of sensible heat So the heat which is responsible to increase the dry bulb temperature to total heat. To total heat. So this also can be written as SH divided by TH. Now what it means that, so if I follow a process, so this is a psychrometric diagram again. Okay. So somewhere here is my point one, okay, and it undergoes a process like this. So this is a point two. In that case, as you can see, it is decreasing. There is a decrease in dry bulb temperature as well as there is a decreasing specific humidity. So initially, the specific humidity was W1, and in final, specific humidity will be W2. Initially, its temperature was like, let us say, TD1. And final temperature, let us say here it is TD2. So in this case, what is happening? There are two heats are required to be removed. So first, let us say this point is A. Okay. So from point one to A, we are removing the moisture. That means we are removing the latent heat. So this is nothing but the latent heat. Again, from point A to two, in this case, we are reducing the dry bulb temperature without changing it. Specific humidity. So in this case, only sensible heat is involved. So if I go for this enthalpy scale, so let us say this is its enthalpy scale. Okay. And this is initial enthalpy H1. This is a enthalpy of point HA. This is a enthalpy of point H2, point 2. Okay. So if I go for sensible heat, so this is the sensible heat here. So this sensible heat will be equal to HA minus H2. If I go for latent heat will be equal to H1 minus HA. So this is our latent heat and this is our sensible heat. This will be equal to H1 minus HA. Okay. So total heat will be equal to sensible heat plus latent heat. So this is equal to HA minus H2 plus H1 minus HA. So this HA will cancel. Finally, we have a H1 minus H2. Okay. So this formula will reduce to HA minus H2 divided by H1 minus H2. Okay. So these are the some symbols I have used now. So you can use whatever symbols you like. And but this concept will be same. You have to take the ratio of sensible heat to the total heat. So this total heat can be added or it can be removed. Okay. So this is a concept or the definition of sensible heat factor. It is the ratio of sensible heat to the total heat. Okay, so based on this concept, we'll solve a numerical here. So previously we also solved a numerical which was related to only sensible heating and sensible cooling. Now we'll solve a numerical which involves a mixed process. So there can be both heating and humidification, or there can be cooling and humidification, cooling and dehumidification. One of these mixed process will be involved. So this is the numerical. I will read it. So first numerical of mixed processes. So the atmospheric air at 30 degrees Celsius dry bulb temperature. So 30 degrees Celsius is TBT, and 75% relative humidity enters a cooling coil at a rate of 200 meter. So this should be 200 meter cube per minute. The coil dew point temperature is 14 degrees Celsius, and the bypass factor of the coil is 0.1. Determine the temperature of air leaving the coil, temperature of cooling coil in terms of, sorry, capacity of cooling coil in terms of tons of refrigeration and in kilowatt, the amount of water vapor removed per minute, and the fourth one is sensible heat factor for the process. So as you can see here, if I read the example, at the first glance, I will come to know it is entering a cooling coil. So this is obviously a cooling process. Then as you enter on the, it will fall on the cooling coil. There will be some moisture will be removed. So this is the case of cooling and dehumidification. Okay. So this is what happens in air conditioners. In air conditioner, cooling happens as well as moisture is removed. So that is the process of cooling and dehumidification. Okay. So anyway, I will write down the given data, and then I will plot this given data on the psychrometric chart. Okay. So entering air, that means the TD1. Here it is given as 30 degrees Celsius. Then I have RH1, so that is a phi 1 is equal to 75%. Then it enters a cooling coil at a rate of 200 meter cube per minute. So let me just confirm if that correct. Yes, it is correct. So it is a 200 meter cube per minute. So that volume flow rate here it is given as 200 meter cube per minute. Now the coil's temperature is given. So that is the temperature of coil. Let us say call it as the TD3 equal to. It is also called as apparatus dew point. So coil temperature in general it is called as apparatus dew point is equal to 14 degrees Celsius. Bypass factor is given, that is a 0.1. And what else is given? So in this case we have to find out TD2, that the living coil temperature. Then we have to find out its capacity, cooling capacity. Then we have to find out the amount of water removed. Then we have to find out the sensible heat factor. Okay. So those who are like still not understood the concept of bypass factor, that I will explain now. So suppose there is a cooling coil. Okay. So the purpose of cooling coil is to reduce the temperature. Okay. So this is a cooling coil. And it has some temperature, that is TD3. Now TD is the term used for dry bulb temperature, okay, and TW is the term used for wet bulb temperature. So I have air. In this case, air is entering at a volumetric flow rate of 200 meter cube per minute. It has a temperature, that is a TD1, which is equal to 30 degrees Celsius, right, and 75% RH. Now this air will come in contact with the cooling coil. So ideally speaking, जर मी एक आयडियल सिनेरियो घेतला तर त्या केस मध्ये काय झालं पाहिजे, एअर चं टेम्परेचर 30 वरून, सो हियर इट इज गिवन एज 14 डिग्री सेल्सियस. सो एअर टेम्परेचर शुड रिड्यूस फ्रॉम 30 टू 14 डिग्री सेल्सियस आयडियली. बट इन ऍक्च्युअल केसेस इट डज नॉट हॅपन, बिकॉज दिस हीट रिडक्शन इन टेम्परेचर डिपेंड्स ऑन ओवरऑल हीट ट्रान्सफर. दॅट हीट ट्रान्सफर अगेन डिपेंड्स ऑन हीट ट्रांसफर कोएफिशिएंट. दैट हीट ट्रांसफर कोएफिशिएंट डिपेंड्स ऑन द टाइप ऑफ मटेरियल यूज फॉर कॉइल, नंबर ऑफ टर्न्स इन कॉइल, टाइप ऑफ फिन यूज्ड ऑन द कॉइल. सो नंबर ऑफ फैक्टर्स आर देयर दैट डिसाइड इट्स हीट ट्रांसफर. सो एंड हीट ट्रांसफर डिसाइड द रिडक्शन इन टेम्परेचर. सो आइडियली स्पीकिंग टेम्परेचर शुड ड्रॉप फ्रॉम 30 डिग्री सेल्सियस टू 14 डिग्री सेल्सियस. इन एक्चुअल केसेस इट डज नॉट हैपन. वी हैव अ लिटिल बिट हायर टेम्परेचर हियर, दैट इज अ TD2. And how to account for this? So we have a bypass factor. Okay. So bypass factor, or the bypass, is a concept in which we are assuming some part of air, suppose X part of air, is falling on the cooling coil and its temperature is getting reduced from 30 degrees Celsius to 14 degrees Celsius. And some part means, let us say, so some part means remaining part, that is 1 minus X part, will bypass the coil. And its temperature will remain the constant. So that will be 30 degrees Celsius. So we have X part whose temperature is reduced from 30 to 14 degrees Celsius. We have a remaining part, that is 1 minus X, whose temperature is 30 degrees Celsius. So combinedly, what we will get is a temperature TD2. Okay. And the bypass factor is given as the actual temperature drop. So that will be TD3 minus TD2 divided by ideal temperature drop. So that should be TD3 minus TD1. Okay. So here my TD3 is given as 14. TD2 is unknown. TD3 is again 14 minus TD1 is given as 30. Bypass factor is given as 0.1. So you have to find out the TD2. Okay. So do the calculation and tell me the value of TD2. So do the calculation and tell me the value of TD2. Bypass factor is given as 0.1 here. And if I go for like efficiency, so efficiency of coil is 1 minus bypass factor. So I have two answers here. Okay. So if anybody asks you like what will be the efficiency of cooling coil in this case, simply you have to do 1 minus 0.1, 1 minus bypass factor. So 0.9, or I can say 90% is the efficiency of this cooling coil. Okay, so I will take Pradyumna's answer. So that is a 15.6. So TD2 comes out to be 15.6. That means I have a cooling coil whose temperature is 14 degrees Celsius. I have air which is entering at a 30 degrees Celsius. Due to bypass, the outlet temperature of air, so air is leaving here again. This outlet temperature, that is TD2, will be 15.6 degrees Celsius. Okay. So this is our first answer here. That is TD2. Answer 1. Now I will show this process on a psychrometric chart. So let us see how it goes. Okay, so my initial condition is 30 degrees Celsius dBT and 50 degrees 75% RH. Okay, so this is my 30 degrees Celsius. I will go straight on this line up to 75% RH. So here it is 70 and this is 80. So in between here I will get my point. Okay, so this is my point. Okay, so this is the point P1, and it undergoes cooling and dehumidification. So I have a T2 point, TD2 point, that is 15.6 degrees Celsius, and I have a ADP that is a 14 degrees Celsius. Okay, so first I have to go to the ADP line. So this, what you see here, 100% RH curve, that is also given referred to ADP curve. So in that case, whatever WBT values are given here, 5, 10, 15, that we also can consider as apparatus dew point. Okay, so very important concept. If you want to find the apparatus dew point, you have to refer this 100% RH curve. So 14 I have to locate here. Here is my 15, so little bit less than that. So here is my 14. Okay, so this is the point of 14 degrees Celsius apparatus dew point. Okay, then I have to join this line. Okay, so I will join this line. Okay, so I have joined this line, And my final temperature I have calculated, that is a 15.6. So I have to go for 15.6. So here it is 20. Somewhere here it is 15. So 15.6 means somewhere here. So this point will come here. Okay. So this will be my point P2. Okay. So I have point P1. I have another point, that is apparatus dew point. And here my point is P2. Okay. So I will repeat again what I have done. So initial temperature was 30 degrees Celsius and 75% RH. So I have located point P1. Okay. Then I have another temperature, that is apparatus dew point, that is 14 degrees Celsius, that I have located on the saturation curve. I have joined this line. I have joined these two points and created a line. Then finally, I have calculated a outlet temperature, that is 15.6 degrees Celsius. So I have located that point somewhere here. So I have gone in upward direction, and then on that line I have located a point P2. So if you look at this point P2 here, so this point P2 is nothing but 15.6 degrees Celsius dry bulb temperature, and the RH in that case it looks to be like 98% RH. It's like little closer to the saturation curve. So that is why I have taken 98% RH. Okay. So on this, software. So there is a software I showed you last lecture. This Daikin's cyclometric chart. Okay, so my initial point here, it was 30 degrees Celsius dBT, and humidity, relative humidity was 75%. Okay, so I will add a point here. So you can see the point here, that is the point P1, that is nothing but a 30 degrees Celsius dBT and 75% RH. Then I have another point which we have just calculated, that is 15.6, and relative humidity 98%. Okay, add. Okay, so this is my point P2 here, and if I join these two points, let us see what happens. So there is a cooling involved, and add. Okay, so this is how the cooling will look like. This point P1, there is another point added here. It is point PP1, and then from PP1 to P2. So this vertical line here. So this vertical line here, this is nothing but your latent heat. And this horizontal line is nothing but your sensible heat. Okay. This value also they have shown here. Total, as you can see here, it is given as 7 kilowatt. 6.98 means 7 kilowatt. Out of that, sensible is 2.66 and latent is 4.33. So major heat is being lost in latent part, and little bit heat is lost in sensible part. Right? Okay, so I will show that here also. So what is happening in our case, if I draw a psychrometric diagram. So this is a dry bulb temperature, this is a specific humidity, this is again 100% RH curve. Initially, I have a temperature, this was a 30 degrees Celsius, right? And I had a relative humidity phi 1 is equal to 75%. So this is my point P1. Then what I did, I located an apparatus dew point, that was a 14 degrees Celsius apparatus dew point. Then I joined these two lines together. Okay, so what is happening in this case? Air at point P1, it is entering on a cooling coil, it is getting contact with the cooling coil. Cooling coil temperature is 14 degrees Celsius. So ideally, its outlet temperature should also be 14 degrees Celsius. Because of bypass, its temperature is not 14 degrees Celsius. Its temperature will be a little bit higher. So we have calculated that temperature. That temperature comes out to be 15.6. Then I have gone in upward direction. I have located point P2. Okay, so this is my point P2. So point P2 here is nothing but 15.6 degrees Celsius dry bulb temperature. And by looking at this saturation curves, I have selected it as a 98% RH. Okay, a little bit effort is required while reading the psychrometric chart. So these are our first two answers, dry bulb temperature. Now coming to the next part, we have to calculate the cooling capacity of the coil. So cooling capacity. Of coil. So let us say Q is equal to, so this will be like mass flow rate of air into the change in enthalpy. So change in enthalpy will be H1 minus H2. So here this, we can break down this process into two parts. So first we can say P1 to A. So this will be again, what will be? This will be your latent heat, then A to P2. So this will be your sensible heat, okay? So here my first task is to calculate enthalpy at point one. So H1 will be equal to, so for that I have to again refer the psychrometric chart. Okay. So my first point here, it was 75%. Okay. And I have to go in inclined direction like this. And here I will get an enthalpy of 81. Okay. So I have located a point, 30 degrees Celsius dry bulb temperature, 75% RH, and I have located this point. To find out the enthalpy, I have here an enthalpy scale. As you can see, this is an enthalpy scale, and these are the incline lines. So from this point, I have located, I have to go towards the enthalpy scale. I have to follow that incline line, and luckily I will get that value of 81 kilojoule per kg of dry air. So my H1 will be 81, and my H2, so H2 I have calculated as a 15.6 and 98% RH. So my H2 will be somewhere here. Okay, so in this case, if I go and calculate the value of enthalpy here, so here it is 40 and a little bit here, so this will be 42, and this is little bit further, so I can take 42.5. so H1 is 81 and H2 is 42.5. so H1 is 81 kilojoule per kg dry air, H2 is 42.5 kilojoule per kg of dry air. Again, how to calculate the mass flow rate? So for that we need a volume flow rate divided by specific volume at point one. So volume flow rate that we know already, that is a 200 meter cube per minute, that I can convert into second as 60, or let it be per minute. So this will be 200 divided by specific volume. So at point one, I have to calculate its specific volume. So again, this is my point one, 30 degrees Celsius dry bulb temperature, 50%, 75% RH. So here I have to go for this incline line. So this straight incline lines, not the straight kind of straight incline line. So in that case, this is the incline line of 0.88 meter cube per kg. Then this is a 0.9. So this is in between of 0.88 and 0.89. So I can take this as a 0.885. So my specific volume here is 0.885. Okay. So if you want to get maximum benefit from this online lectures, so you better be ready with your psychrometric chart. Okay. So there is a book available. You can collect it from the stationaries. Psychrometric chart, you can ask it. If it is not available, you can order it on Amazon. Okay, so do this calculation and tell me what will be the value of mass per rate. So in this case, this 200, its unit is meter cube per minute. This is a specific volume. Its unit will be meter cube per kg. So this meter cube will cancel, and ultimately you will get a kg per minute. Okay, so do this calculation, 200 divided by 0.885. So tell me the answer for this 200 divided by 0.885. What will the answer here? Okay, I have one answer. Others also please calculate and confirm that. I have one answer here, 225.98. So because of time limitations, I will take that answer. Others also please confirm it and see if it is correct or not. 225.98 kg per minute. Okay, so do that calculation for Q. So Q will be equal to 225.98 into, in bracket, H1 is 81 minus 42.5. So this is in kg per minute. Remember the units, this is in kilojoule per kg. So kg kg will cancel and you will get a value in kilojoule per minute. Then convert that value in kilojoule per second. So this will be in kilowatt. From kilowatt, you convert into tons. So calculate and finally tell me in tons. Okay, so first you will get a value in kilojoule per minute, convert it into kilojoule per second by dividing it by 60, and that kilojoule per second means that will be kilowatt. From kilowatt, divide that answer by 3.5, you will get answer in tons. So finally you can tell me in tons of refrigeration. So other also please do the calculations and tell me the answer. Only one answer I have received. pay attention to the numericals. If I have any doubts, you can ask. So already I have received a message from HOD today. Your next semester's elective subject, so that I have to give him. What are the electives for your next semester? And probably this semester will be online. Then next semester planning is already going on. Okay, so pay attention. You have a very good advantage to clear this semester in online mode because there are higher chances in online examinations. Already you know that. But still, these concepts are very important, and this can be helpful if you are going for GATE and other competitive exams. Okay, so do participate wholeheartedly. Okay, so others, please calculate. I have one answer here, so that I will take now. 41.43. So final cooling capacity in terms of tons, that would be 41.43 tons of refrigeration. So this will be the cooling capacity of the coil. And the next two bits are very small. So next they have asked for the amount of water vapor removed per minute. So amount of water removed. So from where the water is removed. So in this case, on this cooling coil, water particles will condensate because we are reducing their temperature up to dew point. So dews are formed on the cooling coil. And this water will be drained. So at this bottom, there will be a water tray. In that water tray, water will be collected. And that tray, to that tray, there will be a pipe. So through pipe, this water will be drained out. Okay. So we are reducing the temperature to dew point. Water particles or the dews will be formed on the cooling coil. So we are practically removing the moisture from the air. These water particles will be collected in a tray. And from the tray, through a pipe, this water will be drain out. So they are asking how much water is removed. So it is very simple. We have to just know the specific humidity and the mass flow rate of air. So let us say this will be equal to mass flow rate of water will be equal to, or the amount of water required removed will be equal to mass flow rate of air into change in specific humidity. So change in specific humidity means W1 minus W. So this mass flow rate of air is known to us, that is 225.98 into this value. So from a psychrometric chart, I will take these values W1 and W2. Okay, so this is my point. This is my point P1. So I have to go in horizontal direction up to specific humidity scale. So this is a specific humidity scale here. So this is given as 20. Its ratio is gram per kg. Okay, so this will be like 20 into 10 to power minus 3. And the final specific humidity here it is. If I go in horizontal direction like this. So final specific humidity is given here it is. Let us say this is 10. This is a 10.5, or I can take 10. Okay, so those who are not able to see, for them I draw a horizontal line here. So you have to go in horizontal direction up to this point. So you can see here the value is 20. This value here it is 20. And if you want to find out specific humidity here, then similarly follow the same procedure. You have to go up to here. So this is the scale here. Is for specific humidity. It looks like 10 here, somewhat little higher value than 10. So I will take as like let us say 10.5, and here I will take 20. Okay, so initially specific humidity was 20 minus let us say 10 or 10.5. So do this calculation and you will get the value. So this mass flow rate here it is in kg per minute. Okay, and this is in grams per kg. So you do take care. So this should be multiplied by 10 to power minus 3 in order to convert this into kg from gram. And do this calculation, you will get a value. So this value should be in, again, kg per minute. So in this case, this is a kg per minute for air. This unit is like grams of water vapor, kg of dry air. Okay, so this dry air will cancel. What we are remaining here, it is with mass of water vapor divided by minutes. So I have two answers. Again, two same people, others please participate. So their answer here they have given as 2.14. So 2.14 kilogram per minute. Okay. So this is the like removal rate of water. Water is being removed. So 2 kgs of water will be removed per minute, which is a very huge quantity. 2 kg means 2 liters of water will be removed per minute. And the last but not the least is the sensible heat factor. So sensible heat factor, as I already said, is equal to sensible heat divided by total heat. Sensible heat we have to find out from the graph here. But we'll I'll just extend this lecture by 2 minutes and we'll find out these values. So from graph we already found out this H1 value. From the graph we have found out the value for H2. Just we have to know the value of HA. Okay, so this value we have to know HA. Okay, so this is my point one, this is point P2. So if I want to find out the A, point A will lie here. Now I have to find out this enthalpy. To find out this enthalpy, I have to go in inclined direction like this. So I will go inclined direction up to here and here. So this will like come up to this point. So here it is 50, 52, 54, 56, and this will be 57. Okay. So my enthalpy at point A will be 57. So here it is 57 kg per kilojoule per kg of dry air. Okay. So sensible heat will be equal to H1 minus HA divided by total heat will be H1 minus H2. H1 I have calculated it as a, how much I have calculated? 81. 81 minus 57 divided by total heat will be 81 minus H2 is 42.5. Okay. So calculate this and you are good to go. So calculate the sensible heat factor. Simply, it is the ratio of sensible heat removed divided by total heat removed. Okay, I have one answer here. Others also please calculate. Time being, I will take his answer. So Pradyumna has calculated 0.623. Pradyumna, can you calculate again? Because here the value in textbook is 0.37. Okay, so same value I'm getting from Rohit also. So I will take that value. 0.62. Okay, so like charts, how you refer the charts, how you get the value, that also matters. For this example, we have obtained the value of SHF as 0.62. Okay, so if you are going for university exam, you have to refer the psychrometric chart. If you are going for GATE, in GATE exam, these values of enthalpy will be readily given to you. There, you don't have to refer the psychrometric chart. Okay, so I'll just quickly recap what we have done today's lecture. Today's lecture, so I have taken the revision of all the processes, evaporative cooling. Then I have showed some commercial products like humidifier, dehumidifier, and evaporator cooler. Then sensible heat factor we have taken, it is the ratio of sensible heat by total heat. Then we have taken a numerical. In that numerical, The tropical was related to cooling as well as dehumidification. We are removing the moisture as well as we are reducing the temperature. In that case, we have found out the cooling capacity, amount of water removed, and the sensibility factor, right? So in next lecture, I'll take one more numerical related to heating and humidification, or heating and dehumidification, and then we can conclude this chapter. Okay, so don't miss the lectures. These concepts will are the foundation for our next chapter. So quickly, I will take the attendance and then we can stop. Okay, so I have taken your attendance. You can leave now. Thank you for attending. See you in next lecture. Thank you.